The deaths of 59 people in Grenfell Tower have been confirmed by the police, though officers have said they believe the final death toll will be about 80. A total of 51 have been publicly named. Scotland Yard named 31 of those who died and withheld the identities of a further 28 at the requests of their families. Besides those named by police, 21 people were identified when their inquests were opened and adjourned at Westminster Coroner's Court, one of whom remains anonymous temporarily at the request of their family. Officers believe that 255 people survived the fire. The dead Birkti Halftom and her son Birkti Halftom, 29, and her son Burak, 12. Their family said Birkti was a generous, caring, loving mother, partner, sister, auntie and friend, and she will be missed by us all forever. Her son Burak was described as a loving, pure-hearted boy, wise beyond his years and known for his politeness, kind heart and his love for his family and friends. Relatives said Birkti and Burak left an everlasting legacy full of lovely memories and their contagious laughter and charisma will live in our hearts forever. We are deeply hurt and heartbroken. Our angels were taken from us so cruelly, so young. We will not rest until justice is served. Raymond Moses Bernard. Raymond Bernard, also known as Moses, 63. His relatives said he was gone but not forgotten. In a statement released via the police, they added, "You are so dearly loved by us all and will sadly be missed by many. May you rest in eternal peace, with love always." Dennis Murphy, 56. His family said the pain, loss and sorrow we feel is indescribable and we have been left devastated with a gaping hole in our hearts that can never be filled following the identification of his body 10 weeks after the fire. To us he was an inspiration and an amazing, selfless, caring person and we feel lucky and blessed that he was part of our family, and his warmth and love will stay with us forever. What really matters to us is what he stood for, family, friends, community, loyalty and love, and our lives will never be the same without him. Hesham Rehman, 57. He was said to have last made contact with his family at about 3 a.m., when he told them he could smell smoke. It was reported that Hesham had diabetes, making it difficult for him to walk downstairs. In the immediate aftermath of the fire, his sister started a frantic search for him. But his body was found later. His provisional cause of death was given as consistent with the effects of fire. Esla Elgwari, 64, and her daughter Mariam, 27, a long-term friend of Mariam shared an appeal to find her soon after the fire. Esla was found on the 23rd floor and was identified by her dental records, an inquest heard. Mariam Elgwari Marjorie Vital, 68, and her son Ernie, 50. Ernie was described by relatives as a creative individual, who was a proud, humble, mature and independent man. They said he will be remembered as a kind, sensitive and caring person with a warm-hearted smile. Marjorie was a beautiful, joyful, independent, intelligent, kind-hearted, sensitive individual who dedicated her life to her children, her family said. She had worked in the textile industry for many years. Through her creativity and joy of life, she was an inspiration to many of us, relatives added. Marjorie Vital, Sakina Afraish Habi, 68, and her sister Fatima, 65. They were on the 16th floor of the tower and their deaths were confirmed more than 2 months later. Deborah Lamprell, 45. Her mother described her as a wonderful, precious daughter, always smiling and helping others. She said to be will be missed by her mum and all who had the privilege to meet her. Hashim Kedir, 44, and Nora Jamal, 35, and two of their three children, Firdaus Hashim, 12, and Yahya Hashim, 13. Four members of a family of five believed to have died in the fire. Relatives described Hashim Kedir as intelligent, smart, hardworking, hilarious, and caring, while his wife Nora was a grateful person who appreciated even the smallest things in life, her family said. Their eldest son, Javya, was described as a kind, polite, loving, generous, thankful and pure-hearted boy and relatives said his younger sister Firdaus was the most intelligent, wise and eloquent girl they ever knew. The family's youngest member, Jacob Hashim, is still listed among the missing. Zainab Dean, 32, and her 2-year-old son, Jeremiah. Her parents, Zainu and Maria Dean, said, "It is with a great sadness that we can confirm we have been notified by the police that our daughter Zainab Dean died in the tragic Grenfell Tower fire. Friends have described her as a beautiful, loving lady. She was found with the body of her son, Jeremiah, on the 14th floor. Husband and wife Abdul Aziz, 52, and Fauzia El Wahabi, 42, and their son Yassin, 20. Abdul Aziz's sister, Hannah, said he could not get out because of the smoke. "The last time I saw him, they were waving out the window," she said. "The last time I spoke to his wife, he was on the phone to the fire brigade." Yassin was described as a lovable, bubbly and caring young man by relatives. They said he would lend his hand to anyone who asked for help. He was loved by so many, and his contagious smile will always be etched on our minds and hearts. Two more of the family, Norhud and Mehdi, are listed as missing. Jessica Urbano Ramirez, 12, her parents said they felt totally crushed at the news of her death. "Our little girl was loving, kind-hearted and caring. She brought joy to everyone who met her, and her laugh was contagious. Jessica will leave a lasting legacy in the hearts of her family and friends and the many, many people who didn't know her personally but have come to know her since that night of the 14th of June. Her light will shine bright and will light our individual paths as we start to move forward into coming to terms with our loss and heartbreak." Joseph Daniels, 69, he reportedly suffered from dementia and, in a state of confusion, could not be persuaded to leave the tower. His remains were recovered from the 16th floor, where he lived, and the cause of his death was also recorded as consistent with the effects of fire. Logan Gomes, one of the disaster's most poignant cases. Logan was stillborn in hospital in the hours after the fire, and police have attributed his death to it. Muhammad Al-Haj Ali, 23, the first victim to be identified, the engineering student, had fled Syria for the UK 3 years ago. His family called him a very amazing and kind person, adding he gave love to everyone. He came to the UK because he had ambitions and aims for his life and for his family. Khadija Say, Mary Mendy, 52, and her daughter Khadija Say, 24, the latter was an artist whose work is being exhibited at the Venice Biennale and whose career seemed about to take off. She shared a 20-floor flat with her mother, Mary Mendy, who was described as a wonderful sister and an incredible aunt by relatives. On behalf of the family, Mendy's sister Betty Jackson said, "Your heart was pure, your soul was one of a kind. You will be missed for a lifetime. You will remain forever in our hearts." Anthony Disson. Anthony Disson, 65, known as Tony, relatives said he was a real family man, adding his boys were his life. He was a loving husband and a million dad. He had 4 sons and 5 grandchildren, with a 6th due in September, and 3 great-grandchildren. Khadija Khalufi, 52, her husband, Saba Abdullah, said they were separated as they tried to escape the building, and police later told him her body had been found on the grass outside. "She was my other half, she was my partner," he told Mail Online. "She was everything." Sheila, 84, a poet, artist and philosopher, Sheila's family said she gave her many friends much love and inspiration. They added that she was a very active and well-respected member of the local community who left behind 2 sons, 6 grandchildren and 3 great-grandchildren. She was previously known as Sheila Smith. Isaac Palos, 5, a beloved son who went missing as he and his family tried to escape the fire. His relatives said, "We will all miss our kind, energetic, generous little boy. He was such a good boy who was loved by his friends and family. We will miss him forever, but we know God is looking after him now and that he is safe in heaven." Abdislam Sabar, 77, named among those who died by police. The inquest heard that he was found in a flat on the 11th floor and was identified by his DNA. Farah Hamdan Fathi Ahmed, 71, and her son Abu Farz Ibrahim, 39, he was reported to have been visiting his mother, Fathia, and sister, Esra Ibrahim, when the fire broke out. The latter is still listed as missing. The coroner confirmed that Abu Farz died of multiple injuries, and the body of Fathia, who is thought to have previously been named as Fathia al-Sanusi, were discovered on the 23rd floor. Omar Belkadi, 32, Farah Hamdan, 31, Malik Belkadi, 8, and Lena Belkadi, 6 months, 4 of the 5 members of a single family that lived on the 20th floor died in the fire. 6-year-old Tasman was later found alive in hospital. Lena was found in her mother's arms, Westminster Coroner's Court was told. Motaku Muhammad Nurtaku, 44, known as Mo. An inquest into his death heard that his body was found close to Kensington Leisure Centre, near Grenfell Tower. He had been reported missing, along with his wife, Amal Ahmedin, and his 3-year-old daughter, after visiting relatives in the tower, according to his employer. Husna Begum, 22, and Rabia Begum, 64, and Muhammad Hanif, 26, and Muhammad Hamid, 27, 4 members of a single family. Inquests heard that they were identified by dental records and their DNA. The family's flat was on the 17th floor and the 4 bodies were found in or near it. Another relative, Cam Rumia, is still listed as missing. Gloria Trevisan and Marco Gattardi. Gloria Trevisan, 26, and Marco Gattardi, 27, an Italian couple who moved to London together. Trevisan was an architecture graduate who completed her master's degree in architecture at the University of Venice last October and had come to London to find work, her family's lawyer, Maria Cristina Sandrin, said. Police confirmed Gattardi's death after his father told La Nuova Venezia that his body had been found next to that of his partner. Ali Yawar Jafari. Ali Yawar Jafari, 82. He was loved and will be greatly missed by his family and the wider community, relatives said. Jafari is survived by his wife, children and grandchildren. He was taken from the building by firefighters but pronounced dead at the scene, an inquest into his death heard. One of the oldest victims of the fire, he lived on the 10th floor with his wife and daughter, with whom he was believed to have lost contact as they tried to escape. Muhammad Nada, 57. The coroner lauded the dignity of the relatives of Nada who attended the opening of his inquest. He is understood to have stayed behind because he was injured, while his wife was carried all the way down from the top floor to relative safety by their son. Muhammad Nada Vincent Chajina, 60. The coroner offered sincere condolences at the inquest into his death, which heard that Chajina was found on the 17th floor of the tower and was identified by his DNA. The provisional cause of death was given as consistent with the effects of fire. Hamid Khani, 61. According to his family in Iran, he had no relatives in the UK. His relatives said Hamid will always be remembered for his wit, compassion and devotion to his family and friends. No words can express our sorrow for his loss and the way he left us. He will always be part of our lives and his memory will live on. Stephen Power, 63, the father of five, was reportedly reluctant to leave his two bull terriers and told relatives, "I'm staying here with my dogs." Amna Mahmoud Idris, 27. No details have been released about Amna, whose death in the tower was confirmed by police but whose inquest has not been opened. A woman, 35, her family has asked for her not to be named. The woman's body was discovered on the 23rd floor and the preliminary cause of her death was recorded as consistent with the effects of fire. The missing Rania Ibrahim, 30, and her two daughters, Fadia Hassan, 5, and Hania Hassan, 3. The three members of the same family were last heard from when Rania uploaded a video from inside the tower block. Esra Ibrahim, 32. Posters were put up around the area imploring people to look out for her and her relatives, Abu Farz Ibrahim and Fadi Ahmed, who have now been named among those who died, though Esra is still listed as missing. Nadia Chokhair, 33, and Basim Chokhair, their three children, Mierna, 13, Fatima, 10, and Zainab, 3, and the children's grandmother Syria Chokhair. Six members of the same family, who lived on the 22nd floor, are all reported among the missing. Yaqub Hashim, one of a family of five, his parents and two siblings have been confirmed as being among those who died. Legay Moore, 79, her grandson, Nico Purification, called her an admirable woman. He said, "Our family loves her so much. She's so innocent, yet very straightforward." The Embassy of the Philippines in London appealed for information about Moore, who has lived in London for more than 40 years. Naruda El Wahabi Nor Hudan Mehdi El Wuxabi, two members of another family of five who are all still listed as missing. Their parents, Abdul Aziz and Fauzia, are among the dead, as is their brother Yasin. Amal Ahmedin and her daughter Amaya Taku, 3. The family was thought to have been visiting friends in the tower when the fire struck. Mo Taku, Amaya's father, is among those who died. Amaya Taku Kamrumia, four other members of his family, Husna and Rebia Begum and Muhammad Hamid and Muhammad Hanif, are among the dead. A family friend told PA soon after the fire, "We are all just waiting and praying for some good news."